Hello. I want to talk to people who live and work in Carmel today about the challenges that have been presented by COVID-19 or the coronavirus. I want to talk briefly about the preparations that the city has had in place for some time for an epidemic like this, and the preparations we've been making over the last several weeks to handle this issue as best as we can. But first, as I think about my talks with people throughout the community over the last several days, occasionally run into people who have a great amount of fear. I think it's probably good to think about what President Franklin Roosevelt said shortly after the start of World War II, when Japan had bombed Pearl Harbor and we were unprepared for that war. He said the only thing we have to fear is fear itself. And that's good guidance for this challenge as well. We need to make the appropriate preparations. We need to use common sense. We need to follow the advice of federal, state, and local health authorities. But we don't need to panic. We need to be careful and calm and considerate and do the things that the health experts advise us to do. From our part, for the city, we are prepared and we will communicate in clear, concise, accurate terms about what needs to be done and what we are doing as this situation continues. We have had an emergency plan in the city of Carmel and Hamilton County for many years, and one part of that plan has been an epidemic. And so we dusted off that plan. We worked with our key employees. We established an internal working group of key people, fire police, fire chief, police chief, various other people that are important to making the city run. Several weeks ago, we ordered and have now received additional protective equipment such as gloves and masks for our first responders or EMS workers, so that we're prepared to respond, as we always are, to emergencies in the community. We have updated our training for our police and fire personnel, our first responders, so that they are prepared to deal with this particular virus. We have identified the critical functions we need to make certain that the city will continue to function and essential services are continue to be offered during this time. Our human resource department here at the city has a plan in place to allow the employees are able to work from home if necessary. Obviously, that doesn't apply to all employees, but there's a segment of employees where that could be very helpful. We want to protect our city employees as well. We have identified employees who may have recently traveled to level 3 countries as identified by the Centers for Disease Control or come into contact with those who have. Those countries on that list are China, Iran, South Korea, and Italy currently. We have participated and will continue to participate in phone conferences with the various mayors from Hamilton County and key staff people so that we work together as a county. We recognize we're a region, we don't stand here alone in Carmel, and we make joint decisions to try to control the spread of this virus. We've reviewed our emergency powers here at the city. And the chance that there may be a more severe problem, although at this time we don't think using those powers would be necessary. We have upped our game in how we clean City Hall and other city facilities. We've added additional dispensers with hand sanitizers throughout city buildings and city facilities. We've made sure our employees that do the cleaning are trained in exactly how to do it in the best way to avoid transmission of any germs. We have formed a working group of leaders from each of our key public institutions in Carmel: public schools, the library, the Palladium. We're in contact with folks from our Senior Center, the Prime Life Enrichment Center, to make sure that everyone's on the same page and working together to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Helping that working group is, of course, the Hamilton County Health Department and the emergency management folks at Hamilton County. We really want to make certain that the information that everyone is sharing is accurate and clear, and we don't fall prey to people on the internet who are pandering to people's fears. We want to make certain that we release carefully considered information that's accurate. We have shared advice from the Centers for Disease Control, or the CDC, with our partners in the community that hold public events so that they can make decisions about virus prevention strategies and the decision whether to hold those events now, regardless of size, and recognizing that Governor Holcomb now has issued guidance that says we should not be holding events over 250 people in one room. We have posted links on the city's website, www.carmel.in.gov, with more general information and links to the CDC and links to the Hamilton County Health Department and other helpful links. What we're told by medical professionals is that the best precaution is to wash your hands as often as possible. Not to get too close to people. We don't know who might have been infected and who hasn't been. There's just no reason to shake hands, to get close to people at this time. And it's hard. We were talking about that. I was talking about it with somebody earlier today and then almost shook their hand afterwards without thinking about it. So we have to try to break that habit. We need to be particularly concerned, we're told by health professionals, about people in our retirement homes, our assisted living areas, people of advanced age, and of course those with underlying health problems such as diabetes, hypertension, or high blood pressure. We need to stay away from those nursing homes and assisted living facilities right now. I have an elderly family member here in assisted living, and I try to visit him on a regular basis, but I'm not going to visit him right now because I don't want a chance taking any germs that I may be carrying into an assisted living facility. We all need to be very careful about that. This virus, we're told, is not too bad for younger people, but for those of an advanced age, it can be deadly. And so we need to recognize that and be very careful and take care of our elderly population. We're told the symptoms are shortness of breath, a dry cough without phlegm, similar symptoms of the flu, fevers. And if you have those symptoms, we're told you should call the doctor's office and they'll give you advice about where to go and what to do. If you believe you need to be treated by our emergency medical folks, call 911 and our emergency responders who are trained in medical care will come to your house or business and do their best to take care of you. I've had many people ask me, what can we do? I think people feel somewhat helpless. And there are things that you can do in addition to the things I've talked about not inadvertently spreading this virus if you happen to be carrying it. First of all, we know that there may be instances where people are going to be quarantined for 14 days or 2 weeks. Most of us have the ability to go to the grocery store and stock up on some food and probably have already done so. There are people in the community who don't have the resources to buy 2 weeks of food. They go from day to day or from week to week. But yet we have some wonderful food pantries in the city of Carmel. You can Google them and find out where they are, Lady of Mount Carmel, the United Methodist Church, and there are others. And they need help. So if you want to do something that helps the less fortunate in our community, you could donate food to those food pantries so that they can help distribute food to those that they already know will not be able to stock up if they're quarantined. We've also been told that even though COVID-19 patients don't need blood transfusions, because people are staying out of public areas, there's a shortage of blood in this area right now for people who may be sick from other things. And so if you're able, and they're taking great care that proper procedures and cautions are exercised in the blood donation centers, but our blood donation centers do need people to continue to donate blood, so people that need emergency surgery or in accidents have available blood if needed. The United States has suffered through many challenges before. This country has always come out on top. We've always met our challenges. We will from this challenge as well, but we all must work together, use common sense, focus on doing what we're told to do by health experts, but above all, not panicking.